بعد حوالي 3 شهور من تطبيق إجراءات استثنائية بسبب انتشار وباء كورونا في كل مواصلات أونتاريو، استعدت وزارة المواصلات في حكومة أونتاريو لتطبيق معايير جديدة، هي معايير وتوصيات حيث تترك الوزارة حرية الاختيار للمناطق والمدن المختلفة في تطبيق ما تراه مناسبا في كل منطقة لديها.
Cleaning and disinfecting frequently touched surfaces, and of course providing hand sanitizer to passengers as they get on and off the vehicle. Public transit is critical to the economy, and it's critical to move passengers in a safe and timely manner. And that's why we are encouraging all transit operators to review our safety document and to adopt the guidelines and tips.
للتعرف على هذه الإجراءات الجديدة والتي ينتظر أن تدخل التطبيق اعتبارا من يوليو المقبل، أجرينا هذا اللقاء مع مساعد وزير المواصلات الوزيرة كينجا سورما. Welcome and thank you very much for your time.
Well, thank you so much for having me.
Earlier today, your ministry announced a new safety measure for both passengers and staff as well. It's a 40 action step. That's growth, right? So can you please highlight the most important feature that would take effect on July 2nd?
Certainly. But before I get started, I just want to be clear that these are not mandated. We are not imposing anything on transit agencies or municipalities. What we simply hope to do was create a document that outlines best practices for, as you said, both transit operators as well as passengers, so that transit agencies and municipalities can have a document they can reference as people start to think about returning back to work. One of the reasons why this is not something that is mandatory is because, as you know, the province of Ontario is quite large, and municipalities and transit agencies across the province are very, very different. And so we wanted to remain flexible. What we intended to do was outline best practices that transit agencies can look at, review, and see what they could apply to their transit agency that's suitable for them to keep their passengers and, of course, their workers safe. So it would be very hard to say what are the most important things, because, again, it's not a one-size-fits-all. But what I would like to say is that, of course, we want to emphasize all of the additional cleaning that's being done, the sanitation of buses and fleets and maintenance facilities. We want to emphasize, of course, when social distancing is not possible, should there be a very busy bus. Moving forward, things that we are implementing are making alcohol-based hand sanitizer, example, on Metrolinx. So this is a provincial agency under our direction, making hand sanitizer available to passengers as they go on and off the vehicle so that they can sanitize their hands as they get on, as they get off, and encouraging a proper hygiene that way during this very unprecedented situation.
Master, all these steps, extra steps, actually interprets an extra cost. How do you think this would be offset, especially we are witnessing lower ridership? How do you see this?
Well, that is a very big challenge, absolutely, and I'm glad you raised it. This is a challenge for municipalities across the province. They have seen a drastic number in ridership in terms of the GO Rail system that I can speak to, because, again, it's provincially operated. We've seen a ridership decline as high as 93% of that, which is quite significant, of course. We've seen an increase over the last number of weeks, but certainly is not there where it used to be. So you do have the loss of revenues. And then on top of that, transit agencies and municipalities, as well as us, we feel the pain with our GO Rail system and bus system in place, the added expenditure of all of the additional cleaning, all of the additional signage, the markings, all of these new measures that are explained in the document does pose quite an expense. But in saying that, we have been working and having conversations with our federal counterparts. As you know, the Prime Minister outlined a financial number of what he intends to provide the provinces. And I think you've heard our premier very, very vocal about that number, that it's certainly not enough for the province of Ontario, given the fact that municipalities have lost a significant amount of revenue, just not just on transit alone, on other things. But transit is a big part of that because they've also had the added expenditure. So we are continuing that dialogue with the federal government. This is not just an issue here in Ontario. It's an issue across Canada. And the premier has been very clear that the number that was proposed is just simply not enough for us. The premier and our team here will continue to fight for Ontarians as best as we can.
سبسكرايب لايك اند شير اشتركوا في قناتنا وشاركوا الفيديو مع أصدقائك.